everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we're making noodles with red curry in coconut milk. We call mi gathi, mi mean noodles, gathi mean coconut milk. The recipe I'm gonna show you today come from the northeastern region of Thailand. Today we're gonna start to make coconut milk, red curry, and tamarind juice because I couldn't find the can in the grocery store near me. So we're gonna make everything fast today. Let's get into it. I have frozen grated coconut. You can find it in the frozen container at Asian grocery. Add a little salt to taste. Add 350 ml warm water. Then squeeze with your hand until the coconut milk come out. Then filter it. Set the first one aside. The second time, add 300 ml of warm water. Squeeze it. Filter it. Then set it aside. We're gonna separate them. Keep the first one to stir fry with red curry. Next, we're gonna make tamarind juice. I got 60 grams of tamarind with 100 ml of water. You can go with warm water or room temperature water as well. Soak it for 15 to 20 minutes. While soaking the tamarind, we're gonna make the curry. I got 25 grams of garangal. Slice into small pieces. Then chop it. Cut the cilantro loose. We're gonna cut and slice everything into small pieces so that everything is easy to pound and blend. 10 pieces of cauliflower leaf. If you have a cauliflower on hand, use a little its skin. Usually we use the cauliflower skin, but I couldn't find it, so I go with the cauliflower leaves instead. Cut the end of the lemon gas, so you can use the white bottom long way to the top green one for make the curry. I'm gonna fill the first layer off. Slice and chop it. Slice shallot and chop it. When you blend, add lemongrass and garangal first, then blend them together. They are harder than other ingredients, that's why I like to do that first. Then add garlic, shallot, cauliflower leaf, dry red chili, then blend it. I soak dry red chili and Thai chili together, so how much you like? Depends on how spicy you like your food. Thai chili is spicy, so you can add more dark chili, more than Thai chili. If you like your food mild than spicy. After blended, you will see a small piece of cauliflower leaf in the curry. So don't worry about that. You won't see it in the soup when it done. Next, I'm gonna blend lotus, peanut, and garlic. Now, the tamarind is ready. Squeeze it and then filter it. If you add less water, the tamarind juice will look thicker like this. To make the soup, I like to add brown sugar and white sugar together. So I'm gonna prepare the brown sugar. To make crispy garlic oil, heat oil in a pan on medium heat. Add garlic in. You can add it as the pan isn't hot. Fry until light golden brown. Take it out. Put it in a bowl. Don't fry until it's golden brown in the pan. When you take it out, the oil is still hot and cooking the garlic in a bowl. That's gonna make your garlic taste bad. Okay, next we're gonna start to making the soup. Turn the heat on high heat. Add the first skid of the coconut milk in a pot. Add curry in. I'm gonna add some of curry. You can keep the rest in leaf vegetable for a few days. You cannot keep it too long because we use from the soaking chili, it will bad, but you can force it for 2 weeks. Then stir until the coconut milk bake apart. When you stir the curry, stir, then stop for a second. Then stir again. You don't need to stir all the time. If the curry starts getting dry, you can add more coconut milk. So now the coconut milk is breaking apart. You can see the oil on the surface of the curry. So it's ready to go. Add the last of the first squid of coconut milk in. Then add the second squid of the coconut milk. And I'm gonna add some of the coconut milk from the box. I had about 50 ml left. As we waiting for it to come to a boiling, I'm gonna break the eggs to add in the soup. Now the soup is simmering. We're gonna add 200 grams of ground chicken breast. Then try to separate the chicken. After it's separated, add 3 tablespoons of tamarind juice.
Add 3 tablespoons of fish sauce, 1.5 tablespoons of white sugar, 1/2 tablespoon of salt,
35 grams palm sugar. Mix well, then bring it to a boil. When it is simmering, add ground loaded peanut and eggs in. As you're adding the egg, constantly stir so that the egg combine very well. Finally, add crispy garlic oil in about 2 spoons. It depends on how much you like garlic. Turn off the heat. Well done. To serve, I'm gonna boil the rice noodles. Use the same kind we used for pho. Add in a bowl. Add crispy garlic oil, mix with noodles, and pour while sticking the noodles. Then add the soup in the bowl. Add fresh chili, cabbage, sweet basil, red cabbage, cilantro leaf, bean sprout, limes. That's all you can have with any vegetable you like. The taste have to be sweet, salty, and a little bit sour. However, you can add flavor for your taste. Alright, thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoy. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you next time. Bye!